We're Lou and Tammy Santini. For those of you who do not know us, and we have owned a travel agency specializing in honeymoon and destination weddings for over 12 years. And now we are also coaches helping other planners build successful and thriving destination wedding businesses. I have a quick topic that I wanted to go over, and it is destination wedding leads in 20 minutes a day. Who would like that type of strategy? Destination wedding leads in 20 minutes a day.
I want that.
So before we get to the actual strategy, I have to make sure that there's a few things that you have in place. And so one thing is, we're going to be talking about Instagram. This is what we're going to be discussing today. So the first thing that I am assuming is that you have an Instagram account that is for your business, not for personal. So then beyond that, I want you to ask yourself, would I follow me?
Ooh.
Look at your account. Go to your bio. I know, I'm so mean.
That's me.
Look at your account, go to your Instagram bio, and I want you to look at it, and I want you to say, would I follow me? Now, when we look at people's Instagram accounts to determine, like, who are they, what are they all about, like, before we follow them, right? We always go to their bio, and one thing that we want to see is that we clearly understand who they are and what they're all about. So the words that they're using on their bio are clearly sharing with us who they are, what they're all about, who they serve, what they do, you know, what they like, anything that would help us better know, like, I would like to follow this person. The other thing we look at is their photos and how they look, right? We look at their photos and they're all lined up in beautiful little squares, and we want to determine what they are going to show us. If I start following this person, what kind of information am I going to get? What kind of photos? What kind of inspiration am I going to get? What kind of help am I going to get? And do I like their style? Is this for me? So we have to look at our own Instagram bios and our own Instagram profiles from that perspective. Would I follow myself, right? And does this look good? And does this do my images and everything? Does my bio clearly share what I'm doing and who I'm here for?
I would follow you.
Thank you.
I would follow you.
But you guys gotta remember, I stalked her before.
No,
you
know? He didn't.
So, you know, I'm lucky she even dated me.
Yeah, that part's true, but he didn't stalk me.
Around the corner, hey. Oh, anyway, okay.
So, if you look at your account and you're like, you know what, this really isn't clearly portraying what I do. This isn't really clearly portraying what I offer. I have too many things that are mismatched. I don't have a theme that I follow. It doesn't really make sense. If somebody were to come and look at my photos, they may be confused as to who I am. They may be confused as to what I offer. They may be confused as to what I do, because I have just so many different things that maybe are personal to me and represent me. However, it doesn't really help that person. The reason why we follow people on Instagram is because we want to connect with them, because we want them to help us, right? We want them to inspire us. We want them to educate us. We want them to train us. We want them to coach us, whatever that, you know, or offer us something, right? Like maybe a certain lifestyle, or maybe a certain look or fashion that we like, or interior design that we like. We're going to go after something that's that is going to say the same story essentially over and over again. It's not going to be super confusing or sporadic. So look at that. And if you feel like you've got some photos in there that maybe just aren't really portraying what you do, maybe they're older ones from when you first started, you can archive those. Go through your feed, archive those.
That's a good idea.
But the big thing that you want to do to start fresh, if you wanted to kind of get things going again, is really those first 9 photos that people see. Just get consistent with that. Start new. Start making sure that the photos that you're sharing, the information that you're sharing, all is telling your story of who you're there to serve. So we just have to keep our audience in mind when we're making all of those photos. So
we have a couple planners that do other things, like they'll do officiant, and the problem is when you're doing all these other things, there are social media posts. A lot of them won't have anything to do with destination weddings. And if you're trying to grow your destination weddings and get brides to follow you, there's just, mm-hmm. there's too many, you know, you're presenting yourselves as experts. And so I don't want you guys to not do things you love to do, but mm-hmm. when you're marketing your destination wedding business, like it would almost be better. Now, can people have more than one Instagram business if it's for a different business?
Yeah. But you know, too, when it comes to like your stories, I know that you guys know that I'm big on Instagram stories, and we've done some trainings on that in our Planner Society. But when it comes to your Instagram stories, then you can sprinkle in a little bit more of who you are personally. But we have to remember that when somebody goes to our Instagram bio and our feed, that is what they are going to see. That is your storefront. Your storefront has to look the part for what it is that they need you for.
Right.
And your stories can be more about behind the scenes of your life, sprinkled in with more of your, you know, what you do for a living as well.
Yeah.
So, but whatever that theme is, just remain consistent with it, okay? And then make sure that, like, your Instagram bio clearly, I guess your Instagram bio basically needs to match what you're showing. Does that make sense? So you want to make sure that what you're saying, that who you are and what you do matches the photos and things that you're sharing underneath. The strategy that I want to share with you, literally 20 minutes a day, consistently do this, okay? And you will start seeing an increase of your ideal audience following you, downloading your freebie, going to your profile, all of those things that we want these brides to do, okay? So basically what you want to do is you want to go and do a search for hashtags that you know that your ideal audience is on the hunt for. They're looking for save the dates. They're looking for flower ideas, right? They're looking for venues, and they're looking for decoration ideas. They're looking for photographer. They're looking for you know, they're looking for help with checklists and budgets and they're all of these things that, you know, and makeup and hair ideas and jewelry ideas and dress ideas, all of these things brides are out there looking for.
Grooms. Yes, like Sarah said.
They're looking for their groom.
Russian grooms.
They're looking for tuxedos, right? They're looking for ideas on attire and themes and inspiration on decorations, all of those things. So what you want to do is you want to do a search for hashtags that have to do with those things that you know that your ideal audience is looking for. And I would suggest finding some of those that are maybe not in the millions. Okay, go to find something that's like 100,000 posts or less, you know, 25,000 posts or less. And when you start doing those hashtag searches, you know, they always come up with other similar ideas. So then you can literally get a huge amount of ideas just from starting with one hashtag. But start with a hashtag. So let's just say the hashtag idea is beach wedding ideas. So you put in a search, beach wedding ideas, and then what you're going to find are a bunch of posts, and they're always going to show you under that hashtag, they're going to show you the most popular posts. So you want to click on the little word recent, and that'll show you the recent posts.
Yeah.
So you'll pull up the hashtag idea. You'll go and see what is pulled up under those hashtags. You'll go to recent, and then you'll see the recent Instagram posts that were made. And so what you want to do is you want to find somebody who maybe is using, you know, they posted something that you think your bride is going to be following. So you're going to want to look for something where maybe somebody just a normal name, not a business name, not an event name, not a designer name, not a photographer name, but somebody has commented or they are somebody is or somebody has liked or whatever. And you want to see what people are saying and what they're asking. And then you want to comment with them, like their comment, or click on their name and go to their own profile and their own posts, because you're realizing, okay, this is just a regular person, so she's probably a bride looking for this stuff. Otherwise, why would she be here looking at this? Why would she be here liking this? Why would she be here commenting on this post? So then you would then want to interact on one of her recent posts and make a comment on one of her posts or like some of her posts. So basically you want to do 10 likes and comments every single day using this method on just finding some hashtags, finding some people that are looking for that same thing. And again, yeah, using these ideas, you know, makeup dress invitations, you know, DIY stuff. Brides are always looking for under that kind of a thing. So look up some hashtags, see where you're finding some brides. You know, you could always go to the big players and go to The Knot and follow them and kind of find some brides and comment and like some things that they're saying. You want people to be curious about you. So basically what that, yeah, what happens, see, because we all get notices when somebody likes our stuff, right? And so we're like, well, who's that? I've ever heard from them before. I don't recognize their name, and they're making this comment, and I like this comment, and they're liking my stuff, and so then they click on your name because they're curious about who you are. And if, like I said, if your bio is clearly stating who you are and what you do, yeah, and your images for your Instagram feed clearly match your bio, and they're like, well, this person is, oh, they're a travel expert. Well, I'm going to need that at some point. I'm a bride. I'm going to be planning my honeymoon. I'm going to follow these people. Oh, she's got a free download so I can see what the top three destination wedding locations are in the Caribbean. Yeah. Oh, I better get that. So then they click in your download. Right. That's how this whole thing works. And so you want to just consistently do that, you know, 10 likes and comments. Even more if you can, but that would be 10 likes and comments a day would be about 20 minutes of your time. And if you just, yeah, keep doing that consistently, it's going to make a big difference in people following you. Get started on that and do that regularly. It will make a difference. You will start getting people to follow you, and make sure your bio's on point with your, you know, your lead magnet in your bio. Make sure all of that's set up. Your USP can be your bio. Like we train, yeah, you in the 20K system. And for those of you who don't know what I'm talking about for USP, we'll be talking about that on the masterclass.
On the hashtags, just to remind, and even though I don't have the Instagram, but I know how they work. Mm-hmm. And the law, if you try to do too popular of a hashtag, like, mm-hmm, destination wedding, that hashtag,
yeah, that's like 9 million.
That's way too, it's going to be hard for you to get, mm-hmm, anybody to follow you on that because you've got the big players. But if you were to do, they call them long tail. So long tail means they're more detailed. So destination weddings in a grill, Jamaica. Now that is
in Jamaica, mm-hmm,
or in Jamaica, that's going to pull your audience down, but it's going to make you compete. You're going to be able to compete for something like that, mm-hmm, versus just destination weddings,
right?
Or destination wedding hairstyles, destination wedding updo, some things that are more long tail, mm-hmm, keywords, they call them. They're long tail means they're more descriptive.
Right.
You can rank higher for those. You can compete for those if, mm-hmm, they're, you know, wedding venues in St. Lucia or in Castries, St. Lucia. Any way that you can make that detail a little bit longer,
right,
yes, you're going to lose some people, but it won't matter because you only need 5 to 10 brides a year.
That's specifically for the posts that you have.
Yeah.
But I would suggest that if you know that, like, once you start doing this hashtag research and you start connecting with some people and commenting on their stuff and, you know, because you know that they're like a bride and everything, then if you use that same hashtag in your own stuff, your things are going to come up in their feed because they're already following that hashtag too. So you see what, yeah, I'm saying? Like, once you start following a hashtag, it comes up in your feed.
Right.
And so then if you know that you're finding a bunch of brides following this hashtag and you've already kind of commented and liked some of the things that they've commented on or whatever, then they're going to see your stuff in that same hashtag. That your stuff's going to come up and it's all going to connect the dots. They maybe already went to your bio, but they were like, I don't know if I'm going to follow that person. But then if they start seeing your stuff,
right,
regularly, then eventually, again, it's a long game, Instagram. It's not
right. It's not a get rich. It's not a get followers overnight, yeah, platform, unfortunately. Yeah. But if you're consistent, you can get, like Tammy's, yeah, been slowly gaining her followers, mm-hmm, little by little. But it does work. You can still steadily gain your followers. And then hopefully they're serious.
Yeah.
And you got serious people that are following you that, right, want to do business with you. So.
Yep. And if you're not following me on Instagram, follow me on the gram. We'll see you.
All right, guys. See you.